This week on NHRA Today. From Pro Glass Racing Windows in Elk Grove Village, Illinois, I'm Steve Evans.
I'm Bob Fry with this week's Sibling Sportsman Report.
And I'm Jason Baffrey with the top road from Topeka.
These and more on this week's NHRA Today.
NHRA Today is brought to you by Mopar, Chrysler Corporation Parts, and the Chrysler Plymouth, Dodge, Jeep, and Eagle dealers who sell and install them.
For purposes of weight saving and safety, in virtually all forms of motorsports, glass is out and Lexan is in. In the next half hour, Pro Glass owner Bob Mayerle will be along to show us how he makes some of his products, but maybe more importantly, give you tips on how to maintain and install them. Plus, we'll have some incredible highlights from last weekend's Western Auto Parts America Nationals in Topeka. But first, let's find out
what's hot.
Last week, McDonald's made a decision to withdraw from sponsorship of the Joe Gibbs drag racing teams effective at the end of this year.
Drag racing, I hadn't had love drag racing. I would never had an opportunity to be in drag racing probably if I hadn't had that first meeting with McDonald's. The NHRA, I've grown accustomed and feel real close to everybody in there, and it's kind of like a family here. I think what's happening is McDonald's, and they've been everybody in the corporation's been extremely good to us, and we've had a ball. Now, having said that, NHRA, they have been great to me, McDonald's. They've been over backwards, I think, trying to help McDonald's in a lot of ways, and so My point on all this is that I want to stay in drag racing. I love the relationship with NHRA. We think it's great for our race teams, and we think we probably got as good a representation out here as anybody would have. There's 24 wins here in the last 2.5 years, so we want to continue with that. And we look at it as, hey, sometimes in life things don't go the way you want them to, so there may be somebody else out there that's going to say, hey, this thing is going to continue. And certainly Jim Yates, Cruz, and Corey, we're all fired up, all three teams, about staying in NHRA.
As you heard directly from Joe Gibbs, he intends to stay in NHRA drag racing. In fact, he has already set up presentations for major sponsorship. Joining us is the founder of Pro Glass, Bob Mayerle. Bob, right off the top, tell everybody, what is Lexan?
Lexan is a GE product, Steve. It's polycarbonate is the base material. It's mire-resistant coated to resist scratches. And the material is 250 times stronger than glass, just in case we have an incident on the racetrack.
Doesn't shatter.
Does not shatter.
Now, it comes in various thicknesses, right?
Right. This thickness right here is what you would see in a pro stock. Funny car side windows, the junior dragsters, top fuel dragsters, all utilize eighth-inch material.
Okay, so you put a pattern down here and you just cut it out on a bandsaw?
Right. What we do is we cut the pattern out. We leave the coating on until we're done, and then it goes directly to the oven.
And we'll show you that when we come back after these messages and the Simpson Brain Teaser. And with his Pro Glass canopy, Don Garlitz was the first to top 270 miles an hour. He was in Swamp Rat 30 at the Gator Nationals. Now, Bob, if the part is anything but flat, you have to have something to form it over, right? Like a mold?
Right, Steve. What we do is the chassis builder will send us an aluminum buck in certain situations, and we'll go from the aluminum buck to fiberglass, whether it's a one-of-a-time piece or if it's a multi-purpose piece. Mm-hmm. Now, this happens to be off of an OEM windshield that we made. It's a Nova. And what we do is we make the fiberglass mold from the OEM windshield, and then we go to the oven.
NASCAR has gone to Lexan front windows, what, about 4 years ago?
Right. They went to Lexan front windshield in order to keep the front of the car safer and stop the tire cutdowns in the ensuing laps.
When we come back, we're going to actually make a part. But first, here is Jason Baffrey with the Topeka Top Fuel Report.
Bruce Sarver came into the Western Auto Parts American Nationals with some newfound confidence after his runner-up finish out in Englishtown. He now knows that this CarQuest team has what it takes to win. He says it's just a matter of finding the right timing. But as well as this car is running now, any time could be the right time for a win.
Sarver and his team showed some very impressive performance in Topeka. He qualified sixth with a 469 at 314 miles per hour, his highest mile per hour to date. Sarver is in his sophomore season behind the wheel of the CarQuest World's Best Oil Top Fueler, and after some troubles in his freshman year, he feels very good about the progress he has made.
This year, with Lee and Johnny on board and the rest of the guys, I mean, the car's obviously faster and a lot smoother, and we're not hurting hardly anything. So now, you know, just fine-tuning Bruce's driving's the main thing to hold up to Lee and Johnny's expectations of this race team.
The big change in Sarver's performance is due to the addition of Lee Beard and Johnny West, who are handling the tuning duties. Beard has worked with several talented drivers, therefore Sarver, who is still in a learning process as a driver, highly values the opinion of the veteran tuner.
Sometimes he's hard to read, but as long as I keep hearing you're doing a great job, you know, you're doing this, you're doing that, that's what I want to hear. It's when he's hanging his head like this and the, you know, rumors are running around that I can't drive. That's when I get scared.
I'll tell you what, for the experience the guy has, and even though he raced last year, he did not make a lot of completed runs, so he really didn't gain a lot of experience last year, but this year, he's just doing fantastic. He hasn't done anything foolish, and I couldn't ask for a better guy in the cockpit, to be honest with you.
With consistent performance in both his driving and his car, Sarver found himself in the semifinals once again. The CarQuest team didn't have quite enough for opponent Gary Selzy, however, and lost with a 482 to the Team Winston Top Fueler 472. Scott Coletta has a great history at the Parts America National and made it to his fifth final when he took out a wheel-standing Joe Amato in the semis. Coletta's crew chief, Ed the Ace McCulloch, had him tuned up for the final, and even though Selzy took a starting line advantage, Scott Coletta got to the finish line first with a 464 to Selzy's 474, taking his first national event win since this race last year.
We really needed it. I mean, those guys are tough. They're all tough, but, you know, we took out the big boys this weekend. I mean, Ace proved himself.
Later Sunday night, as part of an ongoing wager with local Topeka restaurant Pat's Pig Barbecue, one of Coletta's crew members, Tommy DeLago, had agreed to shave his head if Scott Coletta won the race, proving that this team would do anything to get ahead in the sport of drag racing. Coletta is back in the points chase. His win moves him to fourth. Bruce Sarver is in the middle of the second half of the field in eighth. Our Mopar high performer in Top Fuel is Ed the Ace McCulloch for getting Scott Coletta back to the winner's circle.
And now, DuPont Assurance of Quality Body Shop want to tell you who's hot in the world of drag racing. The memory and spirit of the late Blaine Johnson are kept alive in a number of ways on the NHRA Tour. And now Winston and Heartland Park Topeka have found another way to honor the man who still holds the track elapsed time record in Top Fuel. After consulting the Johnson family, the decision was made to dedicate a section of the grandstand to our fallen friend.
For the first time in the history of our facility, dedicated a grandstand, and it's our best grandstand. Most people will tell you it's the one we used to call VIP, but we wanted it forever to be the Blaine Johnson grandstand so that Blaine's always with us.
Congratulations to Winston and Heartland Park, Topeka, and be sure to join us next week when DuPont Assurance of Quality Body Shops will once again tell you who's hot in the world of drag racing.
Well, our guest has gone to turn the oven on, so when we come back, we'll go baking with Bob, and we'll have the Funny Car Report. Stay right there. If you can't join us in person at Columbus next Sunday, hey, call your cable or satellite provider to subscribe to all-day pay-per-view coverage of the Pontiac Excitement Nationals. The whole day, just $14.95. We are actually going to make a Pontiac Firebird Funny Car windshield for the Creasy family car driven by Gary Bulger. The felt is over the mold for what reason, Bob?
That keeps the Lexan from sticking to the mold, Steve.
Now, you got a pizza in the oven. What do you think?
Pizza's in the oven. It looks like it's just about ready to go.
Temperature critical?
Temperature's critical within 5 degrees, Steve.
Okay, let's see what happens here. Drum roll, please. Out comes the Lexan. Look at this. It forms right to the mold by gravity. Unbelievable. So was the funny car action this past weekend in Topeka. Here again is Jason.
As the old saying goes, if you see a penny, pick it up. All day long, you'll have good luck. Well, Gary Densham's been trying to pick up lucky pennies all season long, and it's been up to the coin toss as to how things would actually go. In Phoenix, he threw up heads when he ran his first ever 300-mile-per-hour pass. In Dallas, it was tails when he burnt the car to the ground. Well, here at the Parts America Nationals in Topeka, Gary Densham is hoping that good old Abe Lincoln would be smiling on this NEC team.
Unfortunately, there's a lot of luck involved, and and you want to have that on your side, obviously. It's one of the things we haven't had much of. But, you know, you have to have good parts, you have to have good people, and, you know, it takes the sponsors, you know. If it wasn't for NEC and Auto Club and those guys, we wouldn't be out here playing.
Zenshum used all of those elements in the first round where he defeated Dean Scusa. Scusa took a hole shot, but luckily for Zenshum, the Matco driver had some problems. Zenshum took the victory with an impressive 5.05 at his fastest speed ever, 303 miles per hour. That kind of a run was much needed for a team that has had some troubles over the past few races.
We've been struggling for the last couple races. You know, Richard Bays and Greg Amaral, guys that call the shots on this deal, put their head together this weekend, and it really amazes me we got it this good in three runs. We made some major changes, and all seems to work. We're happy guys.
Unfortunately, the NEC team's luck ran out in the second round when Gary had problems and shut off early, letting Tim Wilkerson move on to the semifinals. Wilkerson and Whit Bazemore had almost identical reaction times in the semi, but the demand flow Pontiac caved the tires, and Bazemore streaked to a 5.03 at 306 miles per hour. Randy Anderson secured his spot in his third final this year when he defeated Kenji Okazaki, who smoked the tires. Bazemore took a slight starting line advantage, and then Anderson broke the tires loose while the Team Winston Mustang turned on the wind light with a 5.03 at 307 miles per hour, giving Whit Bazemore his first ever national event win.
I've always known from day one that I had what it takes to win out here, but it's so incredibly difficult. You know, people, you see John Force win day in, day out, and it, you know, it kind of looks easy, but it isn't. It's taken me 9 years to get here, and, you know, the guys did a great job today on Team Winston.
Bazemore moves into the top five in the Winston points with his win. Tim Wilkerson's semifinal appearance moved him into the ninth position. Our Mopar High Performers in Funny Car are Team Winston Funny Car Crew Chief Rob Flynn and Assistant Crew Chief Chris Cunningham for tuning Whit Bazemore to his first ever national event title.
I just appointed myself quality control. Let me see that part, Bob. Absolutely perfect. Stay with us, everyone. When we come back, we'll have the Pros Stock Report. Welcome back to Chicagoland. Why are they taking a perfectly beautiful windshield and making it ugly? Why is that, Bob?
Steve, RJ spraying a protective coating on the windshield that we send the windows with so they don't get scratched during shipping or during the fabrication into the automobile. The reason we do that is because prior to that, guys would have to put tape all over the entire windshield, and then when you tried to peel it, you had all kinds of problems. In this situation, now the window can just be peeled when it's all finished, right, and we're back to that beautiful looking window.
Did you know that 15 of the 16 Pro Stock qualifiers had Pro Glass windshields? They did, and here's Jason's report.
Larry Morgan has been one of the top drivers in Pro Stock since the late 1980s. However, the last couple of years have been lean. Last year, he failed to finish in the top 10 in Winston points for the first time since 1988. Morgan has struggled in qualifying and racing situations, but he continues to persevere.
We have a new car we've been working on trying to make work, and we'll get screwed up between these night sessions when it's good, and then we'll go back out and try and run in the daytime when it's bad, and we haven't had very good luck getting in. And luckily yesterday we done the same thing, but luckily yesterday we did get in with our old car. So
that run put Morgan in the show 14th with a 7.06. During Sunday's eliminations, he looked like the old Larry Morgan when he took out Darrell Alderman in round one, and then in round two, he defeated Pete Williams with a margin of victory of 1/1000th of a second.
Morgan's close win over Pete Williams moved him one step closer to his first final since 1994. But he had one more obstacle in the form of veteran racer Bruce Allen, who he took on in the semifinals.
The two veterans had identical reaction times, but Morgan's Raybestos Pontiac got to the finish line first with a 7.10 to Allen's 7.14. The other semifinal pair was made up of Jim Yates and Scott Jeffrion. The Mopar driver picked up $500 in Slick 50 Performance Award money when his hole shot helped him make up for the McDonald's driver's performance advantage. With both drivers in the final badly in need of a win, it was anybody's game, and a bit of a starting line burn down took place. Finally, when both drivers stayed, the light went green and Jeffrion was off the mark first, an advantage he held to the finish line to put a Dodge in the winner's circle for the second event in a row.
Darrell showed last week that this team can win in Englishtown, and to do it 2 weeks in a row is just a tribute to how good my team is.
Jim Yates is back on top in the Winston Pro Stock points. Mark Powick made a move in the second half of the field as he is now sixth. Our Mopar high performers in pro stock are Larry Morgan's crew chiefs, Jim Copley and Ed Tickle, who are getting the veteran driver to his first final since 1994.
Several hundred performance manufacturers, big and small, run these 2-inch ads every week in the back of National Dragster magazine. They're called rate holders. When they don't run a bigger ad, it maintains their rate. But cleverly, arranged alphabetically, they form a performance directory. Look at this. Every part you could ever want from A through Z. Just another reason to be a member of NHRA. That's the only way you get National Dragster magazine. For $57 a year, you get 48 issues of the book, you get a pen, a patch, a decal, a rule book, a whole bunch of other goodies. And if you call the number on your screen right now, Bob will make absolutely sure that you get your choice of absolutely free, the Diamond P Video Drag Racing 96, or the good-looking NHRA membership t-shirt. Call the number now, or hey, play with your home computer, punch them up on the World Wide Web. Stay with us. When we come back, one Bob will give you tips on the care and feeding of Lexan. Another Bob you know very well will be around with his sportsman report. Welcome back, everyone. Since forever, drag racers have been using white shoe polish to put numbers and dial-ins on the windows. And that's cool if it's glass, but not with Lexan.
That's right, Steve. There's products out there that are designed specifically to do this job. This material dial-in is something we found in National Dragster. It comes off excellent, does not hurt the windows in any way, shape, or form.
Not a scratch. That's amazing.
Now, Steve, the same situation happens with the blackout here. The blackout, people were using black paint. Black paint doesn't stick to the plastic, and there are products out there that are designed specifically for doing this blackout situation so it stays nice and clean.
What about just regular cleaning, keeping it nice?
Regular cleaning, Steve, you want to use a plastic cleaner. You do not want to use a glass cleaner. Glass cleaners aren't designed to do plastic, and the only other thing you need is a good clean rag.
All right. This past weekend in Topeka, we talked to some pro glass users.
Pro glass, you know, they build a real good product, and Bob works real close for the chassis builders, you know, to deliver what they want, and he has a real good delivery, and he's just the best there is.
We've been using their products for many, many years, and I'll tell you, as a racer, it's a pleasure to be able to deal with a company, make such a superior product, and always be able to count on them. Delivery and quality every time.
When you order windows from Pro Glass, their windows fit the conformity of the car that needs to be, where other brands, you know, they just send you a piece of flat Lexan, and it is no good.
Here's another tip from Bob. Do not over-tighten these screws or bolts when installing Lexan. They just need to be barely, barely snug. You can tell the guys that did it wrong. They get little spider cracks around their developing as time goes on. As time goes by, here's Bob Fry with the Sportsman Report.
This is a story about two brothers. Now you say, what's so unique about that? Well, let me introduce you to the boys. This is Jack. He's the baby. He's 61. And that's his brother, Wes. He's 67, and he's just learning about drag racing. Who says you can't teach an old dog or dogs new tricks? Not Wesley Mattinen. In fact, this pooch is still in his prime. For more than 30 years, it was piloting a TWA jet that got Wes flying high. Now, it's drag racing.
I'm finding it to be a lot of fun and mentally challenging and able to keep us thinking, keep the brain working, and all the new things that we have to learn here.
And that's just the half of it. At age 62, Wes went back to school at Central Missouri State. It was there that he met Jeff Streit and Brian Courtney, who are now his pit crew.
They're benevolent pit crew, so I pay their expenses, but they're not my salaried pit crew. We do this for fun.
And what's fun to Wes has always been fun to his younger brother, Jack. Racing with the likes of WJ early in his life, Jack took some time off to raise his children and then settled back into the driver's seat. In 95, glory was his as he won his only national event title at his home track in Brainerd, Minnesota. But racing his brother?
He's no slouch. We ran side by side in Kansas City last year, and he drilled me on a tree by a couple thousands. And from then on, he ain't scared of me no more.
And based on the fact that Wes worked in the same place for more than 30 years, Jack still puts in 60 hours a week at his body shop, and they've both been married to the same women for a combined 88 years. These boys know how to go the distance.
We got to see how far we can get here this weekend. Be neat to go to the end, you know.
Unfortunately, the end came early for Wesley as he fell out in round one following this beautiful burnout. But what about brother Jack? He made it to round three, where he came up against Ryan Kerner in the near lane. Close race, but the 989 ET on the 990 Index Bells breakout, and the brothers Mattinen are gone. Here are the sportsman winners from the Western Auto Parts America Nationals. For NHRA Today, I'm Bob, feeling younger every day. Fry.
Well, that's it for this week's show. Hope you all remember Bob's tips, though, about caring for your Lexan windows. Of course, we'll be back next Sunday at the times you see on your screen with a preview of the Pontiac Excitement, National from Columbus, Ohio. For all of us here at NHRA Today, we'll see you then here on TNN.
NHRA Today has been brought to you by Mopar, Chrysler Corporation Parts, and the Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, Jeep, and Eagle dealers who sell and install them.